Kubor Kabatesi TV. Lawan Rasha P. Daka Orange Nissan Looms Hopo near Fire Brigade Shillong.
Uba Vincent H. Pala, Ubadang Shushimti, Kumu President Batamai, John Kamigalia Pradesh Congress Committee, Ulakano Bagasang San Pertai United Democratic Party, Kalapendon Kambakla, Yakatanat Kampoying, Namarga Jingjur Shabapalat, Kajing Krong Pisa Bean, Hashilinter Kasurok Ba National Highway, Hapo Kajilla. Hagajing yakren mat ka Batesi TV uba pala uba longru UMP jong ka Shillong Lok Sabha constituency ula ong bakan longru ka jingle ranye ka UDP namar bakini ki kenrom kenram kilakta hado kata-kata ye ka shongsok shongsan Shosho ula ongru bahado menta umtip satya mano babat ya katanat kampo ying hato la undai u menteri rangba ka jella u Konrad Kongkol Sangma lane uba lakmen remboy
I'm telling you Maulai People, Maulai, the community as a whole, they are very comprising and very enterprising rather. They are very enterprising and at the same time they are very unique in the culture. They had faced the problem where HNLC were there. There was a raid almost every evening, every night. There was a gunshot. So they are all fed up of those. So most of the HNLC has gone back to normal life because of the hard work done by the people of Maulai. We have to appreciate them. We have to, you know, we have to appreciate them and rather we have to encourage the youth to be. We should learn an example from people from the Maulai. But I personally feel that there's totally failure in the part of intelligence. Example, I don't blame the police. I blame the government because the police will just go over the government. The police will never go and raid without the government's permission. So the government has to give the permission before police has done. See, they should have known who is Chirisankar. His health is not good and he already surrendered and they should ask from the local people how he behaved. They should have a proper intelligence before they go and raid. They should know who are with him. So I feel very bad, you know, the tears coming from the eyes of many people when you shoot a man in front of his children, in front of his wife. So it's very bad. I really feel very bad. Went 4 o'clock in the morning because I also have a very close supporters from Thank You family. So I've got a friend of mine from Thank You family call me at 4 o'clock in the morning. Very unfortunate, I put silent mode. I was sleeping. I could not see. When I got up. When I saw there's almost 20 calls, then I called back, I said, what happened? They said, this is what happened. You feel very bad. This is totally failure of the government. Why? Because the government is so corrupt, the way they post the people from a constable to the higher level, all are inefficient, incompetent officers. That's why this thing happened. That was before, you know, the intelligence has to inform the police. The people who go and raid, the police who go and raid, most of them are young boys. Young boys, so they have to take care of themselves. They thought that like you are raiding a GNLE or a NSCN, well, full guard, full security, that they didn't know that Bathanki was alone with the family. I said, totally failure. So it's already in the mind of the guys who have gone to raid, must be their safety, so they have to think. So I think there's totally failure in part of the government. There's no proper planning before the raid. It's very shameful on the part of the government. I think definitely the law will take its own course, but I think it's totally, it's not only the failure of the police, but the failure of the government who gave an order. If you look, the entire episode is very shameful for the, especially the party UDP. Shameless, irresponsible the party. In one hand, it's not Lakman who wanted to resign. The entire party came, had an emergency meeting. He should resign. Resign doesn't mean resign, means leave the home. That means surrender. In the midst of problem, how can you surrender? Very shameful for the party. It's, the decision is not taken by Lakman. I don't blame him. It's taken by his party. They force him to do. And the chief minister has to take over charge of it. Until now, you don't know who's the home minister, whether the chief minister or Lakman Rumpoi. The UDP said he's not there, and the chief minister said he's still there. So this is very shameful. I think we should, all of us should condemn especially the UDP shameful party, no responsibility. When they are in problem, they want to they want to avoid all the problem, when out benefits in terms of looting people in the streets, putting gates along the highways. They are the first. A district council is under the UDP, and you see in the bypass that day, judge called me, how many gates are there? So these are all, they misuse the home department, they all misuse the police. And to put gates is illegal in the national highways. So they are very happy to have gates. They have the home ministry with them, the home department with them. They misuse it for their collecting money illegally in the national highway. Illegally they are collecting money from coal mines and all. Whereas when the problem comes, they want to run away. Yeah, so this I think very shameful. We should condemn all the party as a whole, not only the minister. Regarding suspension and all of the police, I don't want to give a comments because I don't know exactly who gave an order. Who are the police? Police has to follow the order only. So, and the inquiry is already there. I don't think it's proper for me to give a comments on this.